Hello again, I'm Evan Ellis, and welcome to another edition of the Coach's Corner, presented by Under Armour, where we give our Yale Athletics head coaches the chance to shine the spotlight on their programs and the student athletes that make each program so unique. Today, we're pleased to be joined by Chris Drake, Cary Leeds head coach of men's tennis here at Yale University. And Chris, when competition was paused last spring, you were in the middle of your first season with the Bulldogs. So let's go back to the beginning. Why Yale? Why'd you want to be the head coach here in New Haven?
Thanks for having me, Evan. Obviously, it's a question I get a lot. I coached at Dartmouth for 9 years. I actually played at Brown before that, so I've been around the Ivy League quite a bit. Always been super impressed with Yale as a university, with you know the strong community, obviously the academic pedigree. But you know, as I got into the interview process, what really became crystal clear for me was Yale was a place that I think we can compete for championships. I think we can have an elite program. I think we have the resources to do it. I think we have the facilities to do it. And I think as we get there, it's a place that we can have sustained success.
So let's go back to your first year in New Haven, because a lot of things happened. First in the fall with the team in their individual tournaments, and then moving into match play in the spring. How is the team progressing heading into the Ivy League season in 2020?
Yeah, it was tough for a lot of reasons, obviously, to get the news that our season was going to end. I thought for us in particular, I was looking forward to seeing what we could do when we kind of had a full complement of healthy players. We had dealt with some injuries. One notable one in particular was Dylan King. You know, I had come down with mono earlier in the year, so I had to miss, you know, some matches there, and he was playing number one in our lineup. So I was excited to see what Dylan could do anchoring, you know, our team at the top of our lineup. And I thought some of our players were, you know, continuing to play better and better. So I was really excited to see what we would be able to do both on spring break out in California, you know, and entering Ivy League play.
So the season was progressing toward Ivy League play, and then everything stopped. What was the process like of getting the news and then having to break that news to your team?
It was tough. I remember it well. We were out in Fresno and we were, you know, practicing. I think it was morning West Coast time. So practicing, then got the news and gathered everybody together. We had, you know, gotten some news earlier that, you know, some competitions even over spring break might be threatened. And then, you know, when the final word came that, you know, we were done with the season. It was certainly a shock to the team. And then obviously you think first of your seniors. You know, you never want a college career to end that way unexpectedly and so suddenly. So we, you know, ended practice, obviously. A couple of us stayed around and played some tennis with the seniors. A couple of the guys went out and played some frisbee just to have some fun, get some energy out. And then what we did that night was we had to spend probably 3-4 hours trying to figure out how to get everybody home quickly. Most going back to their hometowns directly, some going back to New Haven, then getting home. So there was a lot of kind of logistical work. We had a 2 a.m. Taxi ride coming to the hotel that night to head down to the airport. So it was a bit crazy, but we wanted to do something for the seniors because we knew this could be the last time we were all going to be together. So I forget where we got it from, but we ordered three cakes for our seniors, and we had a little impromptu senior night in the lobby of the hotel. So that was kind of nice. We, you know, said a few words, me and my assistant Alex said a few words about each of the seniors. And then guys on the team, you know, spoke about the seniors, and the seniors themselves had a chance to say a few words. And then we enjoyed some cake, some Coke, some root beer. And then, you know, either went to sleep for an hour or two, or I'm sure some of the guys, you know, just stayed up and hung out until we had to hit the road, but tried to make the most of it and at least give them something positive to remember on that day.
Team sports, and specifically college sports, are all about that student athlete experience of being together, whether that be at practice, at competition, on the road, in the hotel. And now that connection is gone. How did you and the team work together to get that connection back when you weren't all together in the same place?
Yeah, it was certainly a challenge. You know, we checked initially, we didn't start with, you know, too many team Zooms that were scheduled. We did a few at the beginning just to kind of check in and keep everybody updated with what we were hearing. But at that point, really the whole country was kind of locking down and there wasn't a whole lot going on. So we would check in on the players individually, make sure they were doing okay. And then pretty soon we settled into, you know, weekly, bi-weekly, you know, Zoom calls just to, again, get the guys together, talk over some things, you know, check in on each other and make sure we were still, you know, seeing each other's faces, you know, at least intermittently, just to see how things were going. And then, you know, pretty quickly after that, we were getting into trying to make plans, you know, and figure out what the best things were for each of the individual players, you know, with the upcoming season in the fall and all that uncertainty. So a lot of communication, both individually and, you know, over Zoom in a group setting.
Chris Drake joining us here in the Coach's Corner presented by Under Armour. And Chris, the resiliency of each of our programs here at Yale is something that we want to highlight in this series. And you talk a lot about the decision-making process that went into going toward last fall and working through those decisions and the phased approach on campus. How has your team been able to get back on the court and continue to improve while weighing everything else that went into the decisions that had to be made?
Yeah, again, I think it's certainly a challenge. What we did was encouraged all of our players to, you know, to make the best decision that, you know, for themselves, honestly, because, you know, team aspects were so uncertain. So each of them had different things that they were weighing, whether that was staying on track, you know, with their academics and then deciding whether or not they were going to be, you know, home or on campus if they were able to be. Others, you know, wanted to weigh potential leaves of absence. So again, each individual was pretty unique. And so again, what we tried to do is just give them all the information we could on, you know, each option and what it would mean if they pursued each option. And then, you know, given that, I think once the decisions were made, both in the fall, it was a little bit easier than everyone's kind of getting on their schedules, whether that be at home, at school, leave of absence. And again, doing our weekly Zoom calls, we'd cover topics from leadership to, you know, all the social events and political events going on, you know, to, you know, tennis concepts. So, you know, and then, you know, doing the best we could to support whatever they could be doing at home, whether that was, you know, trying to help them facilitate some training if they could do it in a safe way. You know, in tennis, there are some competitions if they're on leaves of absence or not enrolled that they could take part in on their own. So again, just trying to navigate individually each situation and help the guys as best we could make the most of what's a tough time for everybody. And I think, you know, that's something we talk about all the time is, focus on the things you can control as best you can. And obviously a lot of these decisions and the pandemic in general, obviously is out of our hands. So focusing on what, you know, we can do to make the most of it, both, you know, as a group and then individually as well.
Chris, one of the most important tasks of a new head coach and a program is to meet and learn about your alumni base and build those relationships. You began that process and then you were tasked with doing it in a virtual world. So how have you been able to continue the relationship building in a non-traditional way?
Yeah, as you said, it you know, often happens organically. You have to put in, you know, some effort. And after I was hired, I reached out to a number of our, you know, our most active alums. We had an alumni event my first fall here down in Greenwich, played some paddle. We had about 20 alums spanning generations down there. It was great. And you know, again, we anticipated, you know, getting to see alums face to face, whether that was at matches, you know, at our end of the year dinner, and obviously all of that got wiped out. And so this winter, I, you know, actually stole an idea from our women's soccer coach, Sarah Martinez, to reach out to our alums and try to set up some small group calls, just where we could be able, you know, to converse, they could ask questions. So I had about 10 or 11 alumni calls with, you know, with our former players, and it was great. On each call, we'd have anywhere from about 4 to 6 alums, and I put together a PowerPoint just kind of taking them through my, you know, plans for the program, a little bit of information about me and my background, and then again, what I was hoping to do with the program, my thoughts on player development, recruiting, things like that, and then open it up for questions and inevitably, you know, it turned into a lot of the guys reminiscing and having a chance to connect as well. So that was certainly nice. You know, I have a little more time than I normally do as we haven't been traveling. So it's been a good way, I think, to spend some of that extra time. And I feel that I have gotten a chance to get to know some more of our alums, you know, through those calls and hopefully, you know, vice versa, that they feel that they've gotten to know me a little bit. And, you know, we've set a little a base from which we can, you know, build those relationships going forward once we can get back to in-person meetings.
So that takes care of the present of the Yale tennis family, but the clock doesn't stop on preparing for the future of Yale tennis. So how has recruiting changed when you can't use one of your biggest recruiting tools, and that's the Yale campus?
you know, starting in really even the summer, but particularly in the fall, my assistant Alex and I think, you know, anticipated that this was going to be a challenge. Obviously there were dead periods in place, but, you know, they were only up to a certain time. But I think we both realized that there was a good chance those would get extended. And so we went to work pretty quickly on trying to, you know, bring Yale to the recruits as best we could. So we put together a virtual tour. We used some of the, you know, photographs and selections from Yale's admissions tour. We used some from, you know, our athletic department, you know, photos that have been, you know, done by, you know, your staff. And I think that went really well. Obviously, it's not the same as walking around in person, but we did the best we could there. We also put together PowerPoints about our program and what our plans are for the program, our player development philosophies, you know, our team building philosophies. So again, trying to give the recruits as much of the information that they would get on a visit virtually. So it took, you know, revisiting Zoom calls with, you know, recruits with their parents. We were able to have some of our players join Zoom calls and you know, speak to the recruits, have the recruits ask some questions. We used some breakout rooms there so they could have some, you know, some private time to ask them questions and talk about things as they would again on a visit, you know, when they're hanging out with the team. So again, did the best we could to think creatively and bring Yale to the recruits, because we, you know, weren't able to bring, you know, the recruits to Yale.
Chris, it's been great to catch up, because we're all looking forward to being able to take Yale back out into the world and to also bring folks back to campus. And of course, seeing you all back in competition.
Yeah, I'm really excited. I mean, it'll obviously be almost a new beginning. You know, when we start up again in the fall, it'll be, you know, a year and a half essentially since we've been with the whole team. It was nice. We had our first years here in the fall, which certainly from a training standpoint wasn't perfect, but I think it was really worthwhile. They were able to kind of get settled at Yale, get their feet wet, meet people. So I think when they come back in the fall, they'll feel like they know the place and be able to navigate things a little bit easier. And then we have another class of incoming first years, you know, so we have a lot of kind of new faces that'll be around the program. And I think the returning guys are realizing, you know, what a great experience it is to be at Yale, to be able to play college tennis, to be with their team. And so I anticipate a lot of, you know, excitement, enthusiasm, you know, and motivation when we come back in the fall. And obviously I'm anxious to get back to work with, you know, the whole group and keep making progress with the team. But I think we've done as well as we could, you know, in terms of navigating this, you know, this time, keeping the guys engaged, you know, not only with each other, but also with their tennis development. You know, so hopefully that that counts for something and at least puts us in a decent place from which to kind of restart again come September.
That was the Cary Leeds head coach with men's tennis here at Yale University, Chris Drake. And we look forward to seeing the Bulldogs back out on the court very soon. And we look forward to seeing all of you next time as we step inside the Coach's Corner, presented by Under Armour.